So I planned on this video kind of showcasing building the roof rack that's going to go in the truck. And honestly, I was sold that it was going to be really hard to do, and I knocked it out in less than an hour. Really wasn't a whole lot to show. So quick montage of that, and then I'm off to Buffalo. Buffalo. Done. So that wasn't that bad. Took like less than an hour. Success.
I came through Buffalo Airport. It was 2012. Drove to Toronto. Won a world championship at the Highland Games. So let's see if this trip can beat that one. It's got a good fucking chance. You have a lot of fun. As I'm sure not a shock to anyone, it's fucking cold out. I've properly geared up, and I just gotta wait. I don't even wonder Andy drives.
In the interest of the public health, smoking is not permitted.
I really hope it's like an old van. Cool airbrush on the side. But I bet it's a normal car.
Wait, what? What is Loganberry?
So Loganberry is a buffalo tree. A lot of people say it came from Crystal Beach, which it did. Crystal Beach is just over the border in Canada. But we took it over in Buffalo. So it's a drink you can just get in Buffalo. It's, I don't know, it's like sugary goodness, but it's delicious.
Non-carbonated.
A lot of people will go, oh, it tastes like Kool-Aid, but it doesn't taste like Kool-Aid. It tastes like Loganberry.
Okay, I'm in.
Let's rip a Loganberry. Oh yeah, Aunt Rosie's. That's a Buffalo original.
It tastes like a melted like Otter Pop.
Yeah, that's how I always describe it as like a melted down like popsicle.
Yeah, that's what it tastes like.
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, that's fucking
Aunt
solid.
Rosie. You
can't go wrong with that. Yeah.
Yeah. But that was like, I got a funny story, if you want a funny story for this.
Yeah.
So Wolf Blitzer is from Buffalo. And okay. We had an opportunity, like Wolf Blitzer heard we were from Buffalo, we were in Washington, D.C. So he gets his assistant to hit us up to come into CNN.
Like us as an EJ?
Yes. Oh, okay. And every time I die, to come in and like see CNN and meet Wolf Blitzer, because he's from Buffalo and he wants to meet other people from Buffalo.
That's a fascinating connection.
It was insane. So obviously there's like crazy clearance, you have like pass and go through it. We're taking like shitty, I'm taking like shirtless pics in front of like CNN, and the dude's just like, that can't see the light of day. That can never be on social media. Of course we posted it like 2 days later. Yeah, so.
In America, yeah. I thought I lived in America.
So we walk in and here comes like the big reveal. And I had a can of Loganberry. We were like through Buffalo and I had a can. So I'm gonna see Wolf Blitzer a few days. I'm gonna give him a can of Loganberry because I hadn't had it in a while.
Yeah, probably not.
So we like walk up, we're all in a pile of people. You know, that's like the pack of us. Wolf Blitzer walks up and he's like kind of silent, kind of weird when he walks up. And then he just goes, "You have a mustache." And I was like, "Yeah, I do. I have a mustache." And he was like, "Great!" And then like started talking about Buffalo and like where he goes to eat and stuff like that. So I just go, "Hey Wolf, guy in the sand, have this video lunch or whatever." And he's like, "Yeah, maybe I will." And just goes and puts it in his office. It was so weird. Oh my god.
And then, he had no idea what it was?
I mean he knew what it was, but I think he was probably like I fucked with it or something like that.
Do you think he wanted, like, private time with it? Like,
my childhood.
Yeah. Tuggenberry.
Awful.
Yeah.
It's a different flavor. It's salty.
It's gross.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
That's how you do it.
I know we've all heard that.
Singing the Matt Hardy theme song by Monster Magnet?
Yeah, it was Monster Magnet.
Yeah, I don't know the name of the song.
I gotta say this, like, so that era of WWE was not my bag.
Yeah, the SmackDown, yeah.
And then I got a video game, and Matt Hardy was on the video game, and I play him, and that song would be on, and it got me back into that era.
That changed everything.
When I got the network, I watched a whole bunch of Matt Hardy from that era, because I liked the song.
Yeah. It was a great gimmick.
Yeah. I'm fucking blowing it, not using Mattitude.
Yeah, you need that.
You need Mattitude.
Okay.
Sam, how are you guys?
Thanks for calling me.
Dude, very, very excited.
He came up just for this podcast.
That's yeah.
Flew from Louisiana.
I just drove up, you know, yeah. Like a good road trip.
We used our big money, flew him in here.
18 hours later, yeah. And here he is, and he's going right home.
Yeah. See the Americas? Going to bang out 15, maybe 20 minutes of podcast, and then head back.
Yeah. Hit the road, guys.
What's up? So that is a long day. That was a sweet, like, two-hour podcast, doing a kicking ass with Andy and Jesse. Back at the hotel, I'm fucking tired. Got to watch some amateur wrestling practice and see what's kind of going on for their show. This has been a strange fucking day, but man, I'm pumped on it big time. Very, very surreal. So we'll see what tomorrow brings, but right now it's fucking 1:40. Way past my bedtime. Gonna try to sleep, so we gotta get this room nice and cold. Shut all the blinds. On that note, really rad day. Getting to do awesome shit with awesome people. Have yourself a good evening. Fuck. Spread hate. Always partying.